Don't forget, we live by faith and not by sight. Thank you. going, shall we? But what's to come? Thank you for introducing the meeting, bandsmen. We'd like to welcome the Grafton Band and Majors Mark and Catherine Williamson. Wow, up there. We'd like to welcome our DC, Kim Haworth. And her lovely husband, Steve. And we'd like to welcome our AO, Marco is here. So welcome all of our officials this evening. I don't think we've had so many officials lately in the building, but to welcome everybody who has come tonight. It's been a wonderful afternoon. So those that have participated in the stalls, I hope you've all come away with some goodies. Those that have tried all the goodies that could be eaten, including the mushy peas and the vinegar. Show of hands, who had mushy peas with vinegar? Okay, there's a few there. Mr. Jenkins has got two. I believe it's a Maitland thing. So, we are in for a really wonderful evening. Do you believe that? It's going to be a great time of fellowship and celebrating. And our wonderful display this evening. Now, am I right that it was the Walzers and the Jenkinses? And Tony, did you have a hand in any of it?
Of course.
Are you just saying that, Tony? So it's our wonderful, wonderful display. So. A farmer from the side of Gresford. Other side of Gresford. Where's Gresford? This is my fourth year and I don't know. But I do believe we're going to be ministered to and we're going to just have a wonderful evening praising our Lord. Now, I want you to remember that tomorrow we have a follow-up. We're going to have the wonderful band again tomorrow morning at 10:30. Okay, so don't miss out. Make sure you get your seats nice and early for tomorrow. All right, but I'll hand it over. Am I handing it over?
Good for you.
Excellent. Welcome everybody.
We just heard that there was a welcome to all the officials. So all of those of you who aren't welcomed in that category are unofficial, all right? It must be that, because otherwise. That march we played was called Go Forth. And it was interesting because when we first got that march out, we had troubles with it. And we weren't quite sure about it. We actually came in about sixth. But as we got better at it, we got it down to fifth. And now we're right, we've come in, we're right, we're fourth. We're happy with that.
No.
Sorry about that.
Don't let that stop you, Dad. Keep going.
I will. That's my boy. Our band, as was said, was Grafton Band. We think we might change our name. The numbers are getting down a bit, so we thought we might call it One on a Part. One on a Part. Good name, don't you reckon? And in actual fact, a lot of the music we're playing tonight was written especially for us, because you'll see a lot of the insignia on the music that has one. So they only want one person to play it. So that is exactly what we give it, because we've only got one to play it. So that's the way we go. But we're going to enjoy it tonight. We've been looking forward to it now for a few weeks, and we trust that you'll enjoy what we have to play.
Am I on? Oh, I need to turn it on. Am I on now? Oh, there we go. Hello. I said to Rodney, just give me the nod if you want me to get up and say anything, and he just gave me the nod, so I thought I'd better get up and say something. Those of you who don't know me, my name is Major Mark Williamson, and along with my lovely wife, have the privilege of being the Corps Officers at Grafton. And some of you may be looking at me saying, oh, I think I've seen him somewhere before. Back in 2009, I was stationed at Raymond Terrace, only for 12 months. And then I married Catherine, who was Catherine Ford, and had been the Divisional Youth Secretary here. So this is her sitting there. She's had all the long hair that she used to always have long hair and have it pulled back real tight in a bun. She's had it all cut off real short. So if you've been looking at her thinking, gee, she looks a bit familiar. And of course, just like you, we're 15 years older. But 14 and a half years ago, we stood here on this platform and in the sight of God and a congregation here, Ray Lottie conducted our wedding. And I've not been back in the building since. So, that's good. I get more laughs than you, Rodney. Well, you know, it's been such a privilege for Catherine and I to be at Grafton. We arrived in mid-2020 under COVID restrictions. And then the day after COVID restrictions lifted, we had 2 foot of water come through our building, severe storm damage, and we were, was it 18 or 19 months we were out of the building? 19 months until we were able to move back into our building, and it always just didn't seem to be, oh, a couple more months, which turned into 19 months. But it has been a real privilege to be at Grafton. How long did you want me to talk for, Rodney? Oh, I'm being told that's enough. I might get another bite at the cherry later on. But look, we've got some great musicians in our corps, and it's a real privilege to have a Salvation Army band, only small in number, and we've had a few reinforcements tonight, and we have some great young people in our band. And with the help of the band, Riley's going to come and play a tenor horn solo called Promises, and the words associated with the melody will be on the screen. Would you like to greet Riley and the band?
Thank you.
lecturer came to the uni to do a lecture, and he got the mic and he said, "Can you all hear me up the back?" And the guy said, up the back said, "Yes, I can, but I'm willing to swap with somebody who can't." Yeah, our band's made up of, well, they're not ringings because I like to play with the Grafton people. But in doing so, I've had to call on, they're people who were in Grafton or associated with Grafton. I've got my son and wife, my daughter-in-law, and they're three kids. They're around here somewhere. You'll see them later. They've come to help us out, and that's good. I mainly wanted Amanda, but I had to get James along, otherwise she wouldn't come, see? And Edwina and Daryl. Now, of course, a lot of you know Edwina and Daryl. Daryl's my resident arranger. So if I want a piece of music fixed up a bit for us, I go to Daryl. He's a good man in that department. And I'm glad to have him. Our next piece of music reminds me of, you've heard of comfort food, haven't you? Well, comfort food is food that you have that makes you feel good, but it doesn't make you any good because it's not good for you. We're going to play for you a comfort hymn because a lot of our hymns tell you to go to war or, head off, war cry, songs and those sorts of things. Well, this one is the words will be up, and it's one that gives you comfort in the fact that you're part of the Christian fellowship. He hideth my soul. That's what it is, isn't it? Thank you.
Hello. Ah, I'm back. It's your turn now. Yes. It's your turn. You're not getting away scot-free tonight. We now have I got the right one?
Yep.
Some audience participation?
Yep.
Talk to us, Rod.
Yeah, this is a piece of... Am I on?
Yep, you're on.
This is a piece of music that I heard when I was about 15. And Mum and Dad were the corps officers at Bankstown. Eh? Is it? No, right. That old. And, down in the youth group then, they were oldies, I thought at the time, but when I look back, they were young. They had a youth crush after the meeting. And I could either go home on my own or stay around. And I used to stay around because they all came down on their motorbikes. And I used to inspect the motorbikes, putting the one I wanted in my memory bank for later on. I never did get one, but I not the one I wanted, but I got a motorbike. But anyway, these lads and the girls used to come and they'd sing and all that sort of stuff. And one of the songs they really got stuck into was this particular version of What a Friend We Have in Jesus. And it goes to the tune of Running Bear. Now, for those of you who don't know what Running Bear is, it's got nothing to do, whatever, to do with a spectator at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Nothing, whatever, to do with that. All right? Now, we're going to have a go tonight, and Mark's going to explain to you what your involvement's going to be.
Okay, so the words will be up on the screen, but in the Salvation Army, we have I suppose you'd call it a tradition, a habit of practice. If you take one hand and bring it together with the other hand at the correct speed, it'll make a sound called a clap. This song has an offbeat. And how are we going to do this? Do we want
to...
Rightio. Did you hear that? Okay. Let's try. Well, look. Oh, look. There's a scent. There's a centre aisle here. We don't have one of those at home.
For weddings.
Well, yeah. We walked down there. Ray marched out with the flag, and we came behind. And the music that played was. No, I was asking Catherine if she remembered Anthem of the Free. Don't say it. Don't say it, Rodney. Okay, let's divide in half and give me a clap over here. One clap. How was that? Let's bring the percussion in and see. Yep. So the words will be on the screen.
Thank you.
Okay, well, whilst we catch their breath, after we'd been at Graft, of course we moved in the middle of COVID and restrictions, and we couldn't have the band, and then we could have the band, and we had to be social distance and had to wear masks, and you know, all of that. But one day I said something stupid to my wife, and and you know, you really need someone in your life who will laugh at you at the right times and bring you down to earth. And we'd been at Cowra for 5 years. I was the associate officer in Cowra. Catherine was the core officer. I had two appointments. I was the associate officer at Cowra, and my main role was in aged care. I was a chaplain and director of mission at Moyne, a Salvation Army aged care facility at Canoundra. But part of my role at Cowra was I was the core pianist. I was the only music we had. It was me or it was recorded music. Came to Grafton, had a brass band, wackadoo, and once we could meet together and the band could play, one day I said to Catherine, I said, you know, I really enjoy playing with a brass band backing me. And she laughed and she said, you're not playing with a brass band backing you, the band's playing and you're playing along with them. And I must agree with her. But I'm looking forward to playing along with the band with this next piece, which is an arrangement of an old hymn. The chorus is well known in the Salvation Army. I'm living in the mountain, on the mountain, underneath a cloudless sky. I'm drinking from the fountain that never will run dry. I'm feasting on the manna from the bountiful supply, for I am dwelling in Beulah land. This is a jazzed up arrangement. Is it from the pen of Sam? Sam Creamer, an Australian Salvationist, has written this great arrangement. I hope you enjoy it. Look out for the three solos. Thank you. Now, you've got something important to say, I'm sure. Your mic's at your feet.
Hello. I was just hoping that you'd turn the mic, your hearing aids off before we started. That was all. It might have been a bit loud. Getting back to Mark and his playing, the best thing that happens when you get a corps officer, they come into your corps, you think, now I wonder if they're going to be any good to us. And of course, there are many aspects to that question, but when it applies to me, I'm thinking about the band, of course, and I hearken back to when the Robinsons came to our corps. They were the corps officers at our place for a while. And I heard that Pam actually had lessons, but she didn't play in our band. And I think the fellow that gave her lessons, I think he's still receiving counselling. Yeah, I think it was a bit of a problem. But of course, now when Mark came along, in his wisdom, he said to me, "Do you want me to play baritone or will I play the piano?" And I thought, gee, that's fabulous, isn't it? You know, I get a choice. Normally they just say, oh, I play trombone or I want to sit on the end of the seat of the corners or something. But here I got a choice. Do you want me to play baritone or piano? I had no, it was easy. I just said, you better play the piano, I think.
Well, and I pick up a baritone at Christmas time when the band goes out caroling. And when the invite came for us to come and do this weekend, the first practice of the year, I turned up with my baritone, and at the end of practice, I said to Rodney, said to Bandmaster, I said, I'm happy to sit here on the baritone bench and put in notes when I can, but I'm not really adding anything musically to the band, but I'm happy to sit here so it looks good and helps make up the numbers. He said, no, I want you on the piano. However, you've already met Riley, who played the tenor horn solo, and didn't he do well with that tenor horn solo? Well, he's a man of many talents because he's also studying the piano. And beginning of last year, he got a bee in his bonnet, and I need to take a leaf out of his book, actually. He got a bee in his bonnet beginning of last year and decided he was going to practice. And his mum and dad are here, and if you talk to his mum, she'll tell you that he practices every day, does not need to be told. We won't talk about his brother. But he does not need to be told to practice. He goes and he practices every day. And can I tell you, over the last 12, 18 months, everyone in the corps has noticed, and everyone in the corps is reaping the rewards of his hard work at the piano. And so I now consider myself the assistant corps pianist. He hasn't quite worked out how to play tin horn and piano at the same time, but he's going to bring a piano solo for us now, that old spiritual, Go Tell It on the Mountain. Please greet Riley.
Thank you.
Well, Riley's going to stay at the piano because these are two of his brothers, by the way. He's got three brothers. And their father is in the band and their grandfather is in the band. And their great-grandmother was promoted to glory a bit over 12 months ago and was the matriarch of our corps, and we're still mourning her loss. But she was so proud of the musical accomplishments of her prodigy because she reckoned she couldn't even clap in time. Riley's been joined behind me by Travis, who's going to play a cornet solo. And we thank Toby for being the stand sergeant tonight. Toby's our principal cornet player, but he's sharing the limelight with Travis tonight. And Travis is going to bring a cornet solo, Angels Watching Over Me, accompanied by Riley on the piano.
When I get asked up home, can the band do an Anzac Day, for instance, I say to them, well, just a moment, I'll need to check on the band. I only have to make one phone call, that's to the Smiths. Because if they can't make it, I can't make it. So makes it really easy, doesn't it? Our next number is a piece of music that was played, at, I think it was the London Olympics. And Whitney, is it, what was her name?
Houston.
Who, Whitney Houston? Houston, Whitney Houston. She performed this, and it's called One Moment in Time. And when you think about it, everything we do is made up of one moment in time, isn't it? It's put together, decisions are made, actions are taken, all because of one moment in time. And the words that she sang have a meaning in life, but they can be applied to the Christian life as well. You look at the words, it's a lovely tune, and we'll play it One Moment in Time.
Well, I'm going to introduce the next couple of things together so that they can just flow on. So in a few moments, a lady who I'm sure needs no introduction is going to come to speak to us, and that's Major Kim Hayworth. Ah, got it right. And those of you who don't know Kim, Kim has the awesome responsibility of being the divisional commander for New South Wales and the ACT. And if you're not Salvation Army, if you don't bleed yellow, red and blue like I do, then you might not know what that means. But that means she's in charge for oversighting everything the Salvation Army does through the whole state of New South Wales, and that wasn't enough, so they gave her the Australian Capital Territory as well. And so there's a structure. She has area officers who report to her, and her husband happens to be an area officer, so that, I used to be an associate officer to my wife, so I can relate, Stephen. And then people like me, as a corps officer, I report to my area officer, so she's like my boss's boss. And in a few moments, she's going to come and speak to us. I've heard her speak on a number of occasions. She came and visited us in Grafton last year, and various times I've heard her speak. And every time I've heard her speak, it's been worthwhile listening to. So if you need to turn your hearing aid up or concentrate or whatever, switch on and listen, because I'm sure it's going to be worth listening to. But before she comes and speaks to us, we've got a vocal item. And it's down here on the program as the Von Hill family, which I think was Rod having a bit of fun. But he's roped in some of his extended family and called in some favours, and they're going to sing to us about the goodness of God before Major Kim speaks to us.
Surrender now, I give you everything. is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after. Goodness of God, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Wow. Aren't they amazing? Are you like me? Are you absolutely blown away by the beautiful creative talent that is in this room tonight? Can we just give them another round of applause? I always get amazed when people have such beautiful talent to be able to sing, to be able to play musical instruments, and just to be able to bless us. It's an incredible thing to be able to worship, isn't it? And to be here together tonight. Well, I have to say, friends, that this is stunning, isn't it? I am blown away. I just keep staring at it, actually, because I just think it's so beautiful and such a work of art. I've got a little secret to share with you tonight. This is actually my very first Harvest Festival. I know. Where have they been all my life, you may ask? I'm actually asking myself the same question, but it is my very first one. And so it's such a privilege and an honor to be with you tonight. And Stephen and I will be here with you tomorrow to worship as well, which will be wonderful. But I think this is incredible, actually. This idea of coming together and of celebrating the Lord, celebrating His provision to us. He is such a beautiful and creative God, and He has created all of us, and look at this wonderful provision that He gives to us. I always get amazed at how incredible the food is that we get to eat in this country. You may have noticed, I'll stand out behind there, I do enjoy a little bit of food from time to time, but I'm absolutely amazed that the Lord thought so much about the fact that He would give us incredible and intricate and amazing things to eat as His people. I'm so glad that we don't only just get manna. And I just want to commend you for actually having this Harvest Festival, having this time to come together and to celebrate the goodness of God to us as His people. We are so blessed. Just a couple of days ago in Sydney, I was attending a Micah Australia Women's Leaders Network where we were talking about some of the not so great things that are happening in our world and some of the folk in our world who don't have the beautiful bounty that we experience. And so I just want to remember them as well as we share together tonight. I think about people in Gaza. I think about people in Ukraine and Russia. I think about people in places of conflict where they don't, and also places where they don't have enough food to eat. There is currently an famine on the Horn of Africa. And I know that all of you have been part of our self-denial appeal. We had our altar Sunday last Sunday, and I haven't got the final figures yet, but I'm always incredibly amazed by the generosity of Selvos. Incredible generosity to fund the work of the Salvation Army around the world. You know, it's good for us to remember that, and part of coming together does that tonight, that all our greatest truths are not new. They're not new. They're remembered, they are recalled, they are retrieved, and they are shared together. So will you just join me as we pray to our mighty God? Lord, we just give you all the glory and all the honor that you are due. We bring our hearts together tonight, and we thank you for this bounty that's here in front of us in your storehouse. We thank you, Lord, for the incredible provision of gifts and the joy of being your people. We thank you, Lord, that you are Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides. Oh, Lord, we bless your name as we spend this time together in your presence tonight. Amen. Amen. And I noticed as well as I came in tonight, all the beautiful palms that are in the building. And of course, it is Palm Sunday weekend for us. It is that weekend when we turn our thoughts to Jesus and to his triumphal entry into Jerusalem, where the crowd were crying out to him, "Hosanna, save us, Son of David." Oh, how we still need to hear that cry from ourselves today, because we know that we can't save ourselves, right? We know it. We need our Jesus, our King Jesus, who rode so beautifully into Jerusalem, knowing the fate that was about to be his, the cup that he was about to drink, the pathway that he was about to walk. Because he passed from death into new life, we too are able to be part of that journey and also move ourselves from death to life by faith in his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But oh, how his bountiful provision, the provision of God, has given us a wonderful life that starts the minute we believe. And I love the joy in the Salvation Army. Do you know, I wasn't always a believer in Christ. I actually came to faith when I was 31. And I'm only 35 now. I'm going to tell a joke as well. Thank you. I'm actually 55. I've still spent more of my life not as a follower of Jesus as I have following him. But I can tell you that, oh my gosh, those last 23, 24 years have been amazing. There is nothing better, is there, than coming to life in Jesus, than coming to the freedom and the wonderful life that he calls us into, that communion of him with his presence. And it was his presence that changed everything for me. It was an encounter with the living God that changed it all. And so, my friends, I want to say to you tonight that you have the presence of the living God living within you. And as we go about our life being his people, it's so important that we make room for people to encounter God through us. That's the story. That's what happened to me. We were befriended by some Salvation Army officers, and they welcomed us and invited us. And I didn't know, but God was working. The Spirit of God was working. And when he got that opportunity to reveal himself to us, he did in such a beautiful way. You know, in Genesis, the word says that Adam and Eve were created and walked with God in the Garden of Eden, in the cool of the day. Now, when I first became a Christian, you know, I read the Word of God, and I took that as face value. I thought, wow, that must have been amazing. I just had this picture. Now, you're going to laugh at this maybe too, but you know, of Eve with a parasol walking in the Garden of Eden in the cool of the day with the Lord. And it wasn't until I went to Bible college and started to learn about the scriptures and about the Greek words and Hebrew words and the true meanings of those being opened up that I realized that actually that word cool there in the scriptures right there in Genesis, that word is actually the word ruach. which is the breath of God, the Spirit of God, the wind of God. It's the word that we use for God's Holy Spirit. And so when Adam and Eve walked with God in the Garden of Eden in the cool of the day, it wasn't really that picture that I had in my mind. It was the fact that they were walking with him in spirit, because God is spirit. And they had a beautiful, unbroken communion with him. But of course, we know what happened through their disobedience, that that communion was broken. But our beautiful Jesus made a way for that communion to be restored. And that's what we are celebrating this weekend, part of his journey to fulfill his destiny for us. And we know that this is true, that Jesus restored that broken communion, that he made a way for us to be reconciled once again to God. And he confirms it when he meets the Samaritan woman at the well. You may know it in John 4. And he says to her, when she asks him about where will the true worshippers worship the Lord, and he says to her, I tell you the truth, that a time is coming when you will worship the Lord your God in spirit and in truth. And he says it twice. And what he's really telling her there is that through his death and resurrection and through the coming of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, that Jesus made a way for us to have that beautiful, perfect connection with Father God again through his Spirit, so that you and I, we all have the beautiful privilege of walking with God in the cool, in the ruach, in the spirit every day. What an incredible God we serve. Someone who loves us so intimately and beautifully that he cares about every aspect of our lives. That's what the scriptures tell us. And I'm sure, like me, that is your experience as well. Well, it's through the presence of God in us by his Spirit that we are gifted with all we need to be God's people. We've seen some of those beautiful gifts on display tonight, used to worship him, used to bring him glory. But all of us have wonderful gifts that God has given us in order that we might continue the incredible ministry of Jesus, in order that we would be the people just as God intended us to be. Hallelujah. I think you're all a bit settled there. That sounded like a very mellow hallelujah. 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 We have been given the beautiful gifts, enable us to be his people. And it's when we actually are communing with God in the Spirit, and then we are able to display the fruits of the Spirit, which are the beautiful gifts of that we know so well from Galatians: love and joy, peace and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Now, we know that we don't do that perfectly, but that's okay. Who's relieved about that? I'm relieved about that. But I know that I do it with an intention in my heart. And it's the thing I love about the Salvation Army, that we know who we are as God's people. And we know who he's called us to be, to live lives of joy, to live lives that are a testament and a witness to him, to live lives of incredible faith in him. You know, the Lord's been speaking to me a little bit lately about this idea of faith in him, another beautiful gift that is given to us. We are given the gift of believing in him. But when we commune with him, when we are saved and free and walking with him, he also gives us the faith of him. That is his faith. In accordance with his will, so that we will be able to do his will and not just our own. Hallelujah. It was that gift of faith that enabled Jesus to walk his destiny for us. That beautiful and humble obedience and surrender. He did it for us, so that we would be reconciled to him, so that we too would be able to take part in that beautiful life. Friends, I thank God for you. I thank you for the witness that your lives are. I thank you that just like the salvos that reached out and befriended Stephen and I thank you that people are in your life and God has placed you there to be able to be a witness to them as well, so that you can show them what you know to be true, the life that we were created to live, life in Christ, in communion with him, walking with him in the cool of the day, in the Spirit. Hallelujah. I'm so looking forward to continuing sharing tonight with you and also preaching and being with you in worship tomorrow. It's great to be here. Bless you. And we'll hand you back to the band right now. Thank you.
I told you she was worth listening to, didn't I? And the band's caught their breath, and so they're going to play for us again. This time, a festival arrangement of that old hymn, at the cross, where I first saw the light. And it's because of that cross that we can have that intimate relationship with God through his Ruach, through his Spirit. And then following that, there'll be a vocal presentation, a song. It's not just a story. But before that, the band's going to bring us At the Cross. Thank you.
I think.
Yes.
You've got it. Is it catching?
Yes.
As I was going to say, a man is here ready to sing, but rehearsal is important, isn't it? And we let you know that we, as a band, we have been rehearsing quite a bit, and it's important to us. And so to make it all the way through till tonight, Amanda had a rehearsal. She had one this afternoon. All right, so she hasn't had much go at it, but that's all right. Reminded me of the conductor that he was frustrated because he had a big performance coming up, and every rehearsal, weeks before, he'd get there and there'd be different people. Different players would turn up, and he could never get a full combination together, and he got really, really despondent. And at the last performance, at last rehearsal before the performance, he decided he'd make a point of it and just mention there was one particular lady violinist who turned up to every rehearsal, the only one. And so he made a point out of it to sort of get the message across to the rest of them that he'd appreciate if in the future they'd turn up for rehearsal. And after he thanked her, she said, "Well, really, there's nothing to thank because I can't make the performance." Amanda's going to sing "It's Not Just a Story."
I heard a story of Jesus, sounded like music to my beautiful story of Jesus, dispel my doubts and all my fears. How marvelous is his love brought to me from take it where
I think it was last week, or maybe even early this week, that Rod gave me a sheet, a plan for tonight of everything that was going to happen, and we spoke about how the evening was going to flow, and we discussed who was going to introduce things and decided that we'd just play it by ear. And so that's what we're doing. We're playing things by ear. And I said to him, look, just give me the nod if you want me to introduce something. And I've been getting lots of nods tonight, probably the most nods I've had in a long time. Yes. Okay. Time for another arrangement of an old song. This one is an old favourite in many evangelical circles. There's power in the blood. I hope you enjoy this jazzed up version of Power in the Blood. I bet you really felt like singing along that time, didn't you? Yeah. You did. Well, now's your opportunity to sing along this next time. If I've got things right. Sometimes I get things wrong. No, I'm right. I'm on the right track. Time for a congregational song. And this comes from the pen of an American Baptist minister. But the Salvation Army picked up these words and music back in about 1990. It was released in a publication called The Musical Salvationist, and Salvation Army choirs, what we call a Songster Brigade, picked this up and made it their own. And in 2015, when our new songbook came out, they included it in the songbook. The words say, I've been to the river, I've been baptised. That should give you a clue that it was written by a Baptist, not a Salvationist, because we don't baptise in water, we dry clean. I've been to the river, I've been baptised, I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb, I've been changed from the creature that once I was, and redeemed is now my name. If you're an old songster and you know the harmonies, please put them in. We've got four verses. Let's stand. You need to stand so you can sing this one. Thank you. Well, we're almost at the end of our evening. Have you enjoyed it?
Yes.
You know, we've really enjoyed it tonight, but we've also enjoyed all the preparation coming up to it. And if you've enjoyed it half as much as we have, then I'm well pleased. And if you've not had enough and you don't have a regular church that you go to, come to the army. That sounds like the army's not a regular church, and that could well be the case. But if you don't have another church that you usually go to, we'd love you to come and worship with us tomorrow morning at 10:30? Yes, 10:30. We get a sleep in because we normally start at 10 in Grafton. Grafton people, this is your regular church this week, just letting you know. If you're Grafton people, please come back tomorrow. And the Maitland City Core Band and the Grafton Band and our friends are all going to combine, so it's going to be a great morning. And Kim's going to be here, and we'll preach up a storm as well. Well, the next thing on the program, we're almost at the end, and Rodney put down me, and he put against it wise words, and I thought that was laughable. And so I changed it, and I wrote short talk, and I thought, well, the band's probably going to laugh at that as well. I have my mother's cousin said that her father said of her, generally speaking, she's generally speaking. And that was the late Major Jean Evans. And I'm afraid when I was a baby, I was inoculated with a gramophone needle. And haven't shut up since. But I was thinking, and Rodney alluded earlier to some of the songs that we sing, and I think of that great song that we have just sung. Which talks about the change that takes place through the power of the Holy Spirit when someone hands their life over to God. But I think of some of the songs we sing as Christians, and particularly in the evangelical church of which the Salvation Army is part. And if you looked at just the songs that we sing, you might think that the Christian life is all fun and games. We sing lots of positive songs, and that's great. And that's important that we do, because the Christian life is a positive life. But it's not a bed of roses. And when we look at the Bible, when we read the Psalms in particular, we see God's people crying out. And I think of songs that I sang in my... I grew up in the army. Well, that's debatable. My wife will tell you I still haven't grown up. But growing up in the army, we sang songs with words like, why are you doubting and fearing? And it almost put a guilt trip on you if everything wasn't all sunshine and rainbows in the Christian life. But that's certainly not my experience. I just need to grab my notes. They're not extensive. But I just want to reference the words that are associated with the final tune the band's going to play. Rodney and I were talking just the last couple of days and said, you know, we really are fortunate in the people who have written words and written music and put them together to bless us. And some of them continue to bless us from the grave. And this lady, a Salvation Army officer by the name of Joy Webb, is no exception. And she wrote these words. 10,000 years may pass away and bring the dawning of a cosmic day. Age after age, time after time, hold its sway. Man walks alone. Now, she wrote this in the 60s. It was came out in 1970, so she wrote it in the 60s. So please excuse the dated language. We don't write like this anymore. Man walks alone amidst uncertainty. Only one thing can still make him strong. In the pain, in the doubt, in the loneliness, in the struggle of right against wrong, somewhere amidst the confusion, there will be hope. There will be love. There will be God.
Amen.
Rodney is, and I agree wholeheartedly with him. Rodney's very strong on us having the words up when the band is playing. Otherwise, it's just nice music. But it's more than just nice music. It's music that means something because there are powerful words associated with it. And so this final piece from the band will serve as our benediction tonight. We wish you good night. We pray God's blessing upon you. And as you leave this place, remember that even amongst the struggle, amidst the confusion, there will be hope, there will be love, there will be God. God bless you each one.
Thank you. Just like to say thank you. Thank you for giving up your time. Thank you for sharing your skills with us. It's a 4.5 hour trip here, so it's, and you're here for 2 days, so it's a big commitment. And I think we were all blessed, and I just really pray that you were blessed in sharing to us and ministering to us in the way you have tonight. So thank you very much, and just give me a clap again. Major Kim and Captain Marco, we got some very talented people in this place and they work hard, and to put on a night like tonight, behind the scenes, things were going up the back and the praying and that. So thank you all those who have put in the commitment, who have given so much tonight and make this happen. And there's one more group I'd like to thank. You know, they say Harvest Festivals are dead. We'll get the crowd here tonight. Thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting the Harvest Festival here, but also thank you for supporting the talent we have at the front. I hope you've had a great night, and like you said, if you've got nowhere to go tomorrow, please come back and join us, or Captain Marco's preaching next Sunday. As we know, Jesus Christ too is not dead also. Thanks a lot, and have a safe trip home.